morning. Kevin Martin here, your UT admissions guide, here today to discuss tips and strategies for approaching the UT Austin new short answer prompt, asking you to discuss and share reasons why you're choosing your first choice major. So all students, all first-time freshmen must write around one page, so around 300 words, why are you interested in the major you indicated as your first choice major? And this is, I see it as a change from the previous short answer prompt that required all students to discuss their future career interests. I think by narrowing down the prompt a little bit, it makes the job of the applicant a little bit easier because you're not having to discuss your academic interests and how that ties into your future career. So you can just, you know, focus explicitly on, you know, where you want to be, you know, in the next year or two and how you think that might possibly help you achieve your long-term goals. So I have 8 tips and pieces of advice and approaches for this new short answer prompt. So the first piece of advice is, look, it's just UT Austin system that you have to choose a first choice major. I know this can be frustrating because there's all these different possibilities. You're 17 or 18 years old and you may have no idea what it is you want to study or what you want to do. And it can be frustrating. I know some universities like Rice, for example, allow you to just gain admission to the university and figure it out when you get there. But again, if your UT Austin is your first choice, you're going to have to play the game and reference detailed specific experiences that demonstrate your fit for your first choice major. My second piece of advice is to locate a specialty within your major. So almost all majors have subfields, tracks, specialties, or concentrations. For example, in biology, I think there's 9 different tracks you can take, from marine ecology to botany to cell biology. Aerospace engineering, for example, has either atmospheric, so like planes and helicopters, or space, so like satellites or other types of space travel. And so discuss one or two of these subfields or tracks that might interest you. 3, and this is critical, you should highlight previous or current experiences that are academic, extracurricular, professional, or independent studies that tie in or influence, perhaps motivate or inspire your choice of your first choice major, and again, a potential specialty within that field. 4, I encourage you to identify, research, locate UT professors and courses that match your interest. So if within biology, for example, if there's 9 different subfields, you can imagine within each of those subfields there might be a dozen or more different professors. And so it's really important to go beyond the rankings or the prestige or your future career or earnings. I think this is particularly true with applicants to the McCombs School of Business. They'll say things like, it's the number 6 ranked business school in the United States and the number 1 accounting program, you know, in America or in the world. But all departments list their faculty, the courses, the curriculum, even the actual like syllabi. You can find like exactly what like UT students are taking. You can also find research centers. So all academic units, whether they're the hard sciences like chemistry or biology, or linguistics or social work, all have research units at UT Austin. So, you know, go beyond just the surface level and dig a little bit deeper. And if you want to dive even deeper, this is a really cool strategy that I think works well for at least some applicants who are willing to find articles, blog posts, perhaps opinion pieces in Austin American Statesman or the New York Times or Dallas Morning News. You can find podcasts that your professors have put forward, either as their own work or perhaps an interview, and you can discuss how these types of material might influence your first choice major. My 5th piece of advice is to research related student organizations or academic resources. So the college experience is not confined to the classroom. It might be quite similar to how you're experiencing high school now. There's one really useful database called Horns Link that has a collection of all the different student organizations, the people who are in charge, or websites related to those organizations. Moreover, every college and school and major or like pre-professional organization like pre-health or pre-dentistry or pre-physical therapy all have relevant student organizations. And so consider finding extracurricular activities that influence your first choice major and in turn demonstrate how UT Austin is a great fit for you personally. 6, I think it's also appropriate to consider certifications, minors, or even courses outside of your specific major. So one example that I participated in that served me very well during UT Austin was the Bridging Disciplines program. Bridging Disciplines allowed me to connect my academic research with some fieldwork that I had done overseas and also allowed me to take different courses that were not specifically related to my majors. You can also have a minor in business, so any student used to be able to do a Business Foundation certificate, but if you're a student who wants to build their business competencies, You can take a business minor. There's also an elements of computing, computer science certificate. Or if you're a STEM or business-oriented student, you can also earn a certificate in core texts and ideas, where you get to explore kind of the great thinkers throughout civilization. And you can also get a creative writing certificate. I think UT has like over 50 of these different certification programs. And so your essays are not a contract, whether it's a research or a professor you want to take a course with or a certificate. But I think just identifying one or two of these opportunities can demonstrate to reviewers that you've done a little bit of research and you're making an informed decision about why UT is a great fit for you. Seventh, and I think this is related particularly to if you want to discuss also your career ambitions, is specifically discuss how Austin as a city can help you further your professional, academic, and leadership goals. And so that's one obvious advantage of attending UT Austin, is it's like a mile away from the state capital. It's a, you know, a hub for technology, telecommunications, for even things like film, and the movie industry is booming in the city of Austin right now. So I think especially if you're applying as an out-of-state student, right? Like if you're applying to, you know, UT Austin and Georgia Tech and California and University of Washington, I think it's important to put forward compelling reasons why there are opportunities unique that will help you achieve your goals that you may not have access to in your home state or your public universities close to you. You can also research Austin-specific opportunities and resources, and it's also really important to avoid generalizations and cliches. Like, of course, if you're an artistically inclined or musically inclined student, like Austin is like this epicenter of wonderful music and television, for example. But don't just say like Austin is this great, you know, there's 200 live music venues, but instead you could, you know, talk about potential artistic influences that may have had their own starts in Austin. And so just avoid these broad generalizations about you like Austin being a beautiful city with great nature. Instead, you know, talk about, you know, maybe visiting Barton Creek or heading out to the Hill Country to go camping. Finally, I think this is relevant if you have any personal or family circumstances that inform your first choice major. Like, for example, if your parent lost a job and now you understand the importance of business skills or perhaps having a stable income. I think particularly if you've experienced any mental health issues personally or within your family, or if you've lost a loved one, or perhaps you have an aging grandparent, I think these can all influence potential majors in things like education, psychology, nutrition, or social work, for example, if you come from a low-income community and you see that there's a high need for different types of outreach. I think if you have a sibling, for example, who has a speech difference or a learning disorder, is perhaps on the autism spectrum, maybe that influences your decision to study speech-language pathology. So again, I hope that these are all tips that will give you some food for thought and different ways to narrow down and expand the definition of what it means to put forward an argument of like why you're choosing UT Austin or why you're selecting your first choice major. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I will be releasing 3 more on the other short answers throughout the summer. As always, if you like this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you're interested in working together, you can complete my free questionnaire that you can find in the information section of this video. I can provide an admissions consultation for free and also discuss what we can do to help maximize your admissions chances. Thanks, and I hope you have a great day.